Hello friends, welcome to Srivali's kitchen. Now I am going to show how to prepare a chutney with methi leaves. Firstly, we have to remove the leaves from the stems, wash them once, and then we are going to saute them, soften them up along with green chilies. Okay, make sure you wash your leaves properly. While these leaves are getting softened, we are going to prepare the tempering. We already have the oil hot. We add urad dal, good quantity, mustard seeds, cumin seeds, and a few pieces of dry red chili. We get the spice only from the green chilies and the dry red chilies. So we need to add a good quantity of that. Not to forget asafoetida. Right. The tempering is almost done and the leaves are getting cooked. And what we do is we divide the tempering into two parts. 70% of it goes into the mixer jar and we grind it once. To that we add these cooked leaves along with some salt and some tamarind. We grind it again into a fine paste. You can add some water if you want, not too much. Then once you are done with making the paste, you add the remaining tempering to it and mix it. This chutney is very simple, very tasty, and it tastes good with plain rice, idli, dosa, roti, and moreover, you can make it in a little larger quantity and store it in the fridge, and it will taste good for at least 3 days. So you can have it with your morning breakfast, or in your lunch, or in your dinner. But remember to make sure that these are not too hot when you add it into the mixer. So just let these cool down for a bit and then you can add it to the mix. But till then you have to make sure that this water evaporates. The leaves are still a little raw and raw leaves do not really taste that good. The reason we are adding tamarind is because the methi leaves have a typical taste, a very different one, and we need to counter it. What can be better to counter a taste like that apart from tamarind? And if you do want, maybe you can add say half a spoon of sugar or a tiny bit of jaggery to get a mild sweetness to this. That also enhances the flavor. So this is going to take another minute or two and then we are going to let this cool down while our tempering is cooling down, and then we are going to grind everything to make the chutney. Once the tempering has cooled down and even the leaves have been cooked and cooled, I've ground it into this paste and kept the remaining tempering ready. So now I'm going to add this tempering to this. Give it a mix. And transfer it to the serving bowl. You can see this beautiful dark green color. It's good. That comes from shading of the green chili, red chilies, and the methi. This methi leaf chutney is now ready to serve. and eat. You can have it along with rice, idli, dosa, and like I said, you can store it for 3 days. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, do subscribe to Srivalli's Kitchen. Thank you.